Hi friends, welcome back to Hobby Plus. Today I will discuss about this Snubber circuit. I already discussed everything in my Snubber circuit video, but in this video I ask a question: what is the purpose of this capacitor? Today I discuss this. If you don't use this Snubber circuit, you get the output pulse and ringing. You also get a output pulse, no problem, but you also get a ringing top and bottom of the pulse. So if you use this Snubber circuit, you get a pulse like that. See this, there is a slope, and that is the main cause. If you use this capacitor here, you can get this slope. If you use this capacitor, you also release some trace from this resistance. Now at first I tell you how this capacitor is work. That is your 310 volt DC. When you put this capacitor here, your DC voltage come through this path, because DC cannot through this path, through the capacitor. You know that DC always blocked by the capacitor, and this point also goes to 320 volt. If you measure this voltage from the ground, respect to ground, you get here 310 volt due to this resistance. When your high voltage come through this path, I tell everything in my Snubber circuit calculation, you get a high voltage here. Why? When you get this, you know that, then through the diode power supply come here and charge the capacitor, and little voltage through this path, because that is your high point, that is your low point. So some voltage stored in this capacitor, some voltage go through this path. When this MOSFET is off, that is off condition, when your MOSFET is on, total voltage goes through this path. In that moment, here is a high voltage, but that is a reverse diode. In that moment, that is a high voltage, that is a low voltage. So the voltage cannot go through this path, so capacitor discharge through this resistance. Now you also remember one thing, that is your ringing frequency. How to calculate this, I told everything. And you get a wattage from this formula, you know that. Now here is a formula, you can calculate your capacitor value. What it is? C is equal to 1 by 2 into pi into RF, that is ringing frequency, and L. I make a video about this L, that is your L means that is your primary coil inductance. That is your primary coil inductance. How to calculate this, I already told in my last video. You just follow this video, you can calculate this value. So you need to calculate this value, calculative value you have to put here, and you get a C value of this formula. And it is one more thing I have to tell you. You have to convert this kilohertz to hertz, and L convert to Henry, then you get the capacitor value in farad. You must do this. After that you transfer to farad, to nanofarad, picofarad, microfarad, whatever it is. That is the way to calculate this. Now you get your capacitor value here. Fine. Now how can I calculate the voltage of this capacitor? That is important also, you know. Now look this. When your switching device turned off, ringing generate here, you use this snubber in here, so your ringing goes to stop. Good enough. You get a double of the supply voltage from this point, and ringing voltage is 300. I already show you. So 310 plus 300, 620. Sorry, 610 volt. And you know there is a RDS on. You know that. In the MOSFET there is a RDS on. That means that is a resistance part. When it is start on, when it is start and goes to on, there is a resistance, and that is the internal capacitance of this MOSFET. So that is also a tank circuit, so it also resonate automatically. So you get more voltage here. So 300 plus 310 plus 310 volt also here there, and some other voltage generate from the circuit. So that is approx 1 kilovolt, and you know the voltage, that is a thumb rule. If you get here 1 kV, then you just multiply into 2, and that is your capacitor voltage. That means 2 kV. That means you get a value from this formula, and you get the voltage from this way. So if you put this and make this circuit in here, then you get a pulse something like that, and that is the best pulse for output, you know. But I have attached two components here. One is capacitor, another is resistance. You just tell me why I put this device here, why I put this component here, what is the purpose? If you know, very good, tell me that in my comment box. If you don't know that, that also tell me in my comment box. Hope this video is helpful. You know what to do. If it is helpful, please do this. Thank you. Thank you for watching.